奉主耶稣基督圣名，跟大家一起来分享圣经的真理。
In the name of Jesus, I'll share with you the Bible's teaching.
我们先来看马太福音第七章。
Let's firstly turn to Matthew chapter 7.
马太福音第七章十三节跟十四节。
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13 and 14.
我们在这段经文里面可以看到耶稣基督他这样告诉我们。
So in this passage, we can see what Lord Jesus tells us.
他说你们要进窄门。
It says, enter by the narrow gate.
因为引到永生那个门是窄的，路是小的。
For narrow is the way that leads to salvation.
那如果要引人进入到灭亡的境界里面。
If we want to lead people to destruction.
耶稣告诉我们说门是宽的，路也是大的。
Lord Jesus says, wide is the gate and broad is the way.
那这个窄门在它的原文上也是单数讲一个门。
And when it talks about the narrow gate, in the original text, it's also singular, one gate.
所以主耶稣他告诉我们说，你们要进入那一个唯一的一个窄门。
So Lord Jesus says, enter by the narrow gate.
那为什么说我们得救要进入那唯一个那一个窄门呢？
So why does it say we have to enter by the narrow gate if we want to go to lead to salvation?
因为教会是我们的耶稣基督，他曾经说过在这个地面上要建立拯救人灵魂的一个属他的存在。
Because church is the place where Lord Jesus established on earth, which has the authority to save people's souls.
那既然是我们天上的神耶稣基督他亲手所要建造的，那么拯救人灵魂的教会。
Now since the church is established personally by our God and it is here to save the souls of mankind,
那就有我们天上的神耶稣所说的教会的条件，在让人灵魂得救的教会身上。
Thus, there must be requirements which the church must meet so that it's able to do so.
当我们在经营一间教会的时候，我们必须要有圣经真理的规范。
So if you want to run a church, you must be confined within the teachings of the Bible.
我们绝对不可以用着我们人的思想观念。
So we cannot rely simply on human thoughts or our own idea or interpretations.
好像马太福音十五章第九节耶稣所说的。
Like in Matthew chapter 15 verse 9, Jesus says,
耶稣说如果把人的吩咐当成真理来教导人。
That if we teach the commandments of men, it's doctrines to teach.
那么拜我呢是浪费时间的。
Then these people worship me in vain. It is pointless.
换句话说，我们在教会里面，我们所传讲的这些讯息。
In another word, all the words that we preach in the church.
那么它一定要有这本圣经真理的规范。
It must be confined within the rules or the guidelines of the Bible.
如果我们所传说的，我们所传讲的，在这本圣经里面找不到神给我们的根据。
If whatever we preach is not in accordance to what's written in the Bible,
它是出自于我们人的一种思想，是一种我们创造出来的观念做法。
And then instead, it came from the ideas of men or our own thinking.
那如果是这样子的话，那这个就不是神的真理。
If that is the case, then that is not God's truth.
那既然不是神的真理，我们今天聚集一起，说在敬拜天上的神。对不起，神是不会跟我们同在的。
And if we're not actually teaching and preaching the truth of God, then even if we gather here today, God is not with us.
所以我们要按照圣经神所告诉我们的。
That is why we must do according to what God has told us in this Bible.
我们一起来分享，到底这一间神的教会，我们的神说他必须要有什么样的条件。
And then we can learn what criteria this church must have.
第一个我们来看提摩太前书三章十五节。
Firstly, let us turn to 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 15.
在提摩太前书三章十五节是保罗写信给提摩太的一句话。
So this is a word that Paul has written to Timothy.
因为保罗他是一个世界性的传道工人。
Now Paul was a preacher who went around the world back then.
所以他常常为了耶稣基督福音的缘故，那么他走遍全世界。
And so he traveled around the world for the gospel of Christ.
所以保罗告诉他的接班人提摩太说，如果我在外面时间耽搁了。
And so he tells Timothy that if I'm delayed,
我没有办法按照我预定的时间回到你那边。
And that I cannot return to you by the appointed time.
那保罗告诉提摩太说，你要知道哦，在神的家里面怎么做呢？
And then so he tells him, you should know how you ought to conduct yourself in the house of God.
好，那么圣经我们的神给保罗的冠冕说，这个家就是神的教会。
And then it says the house of God is the church of the living God.
提摩太呀，你在神的教会里面，你要怎么做呢？
So Timothy, you in the church of God, what should you do?
最后这一句话说，教会是建立在真理的柱石和根基上面。
And then lastly, it says this church is built on the pillar and the ground of the truth.
所以换句话说，教会必须要具备的条件就是要站在真理上面。
In another word, one of the criteria to be a church that saves is that it must stand on the truth.
站在神的话语上面，我们去建造我们信仰的属灵工厂。
So our the building of our faith must be established on the truth.
那么这样子的一间教会，它才是神的教会。
And a church that is built like this is the church of God.
我七八年前曾经代表我们这个台湾的真耶稣教会到大陆去开会。
Now, about several years ago, on behalf of the TJC in Taiwan, I went to China for a meeting, a conference.
因为那个时候这个两岸互通性非常好，包括宗教都可以互通。
Now, back then, it was there was mutual and reciprocal agreement between Taiwan and China. And religiously, we could also go over.
所以中国大陆的基督教他们就邀请台湾的基督教，他们举办了一个举办了一个基督教论坛的会议。
And so Christian denominations, they invited the Christian churches from Taiwan and held a conference.
那么它的名称叫两岸基督教交流学会。
And it was a conference for a fellowship and for teaching among the Christian churches.
那么他们所设定的这个讨论的主题是什么呢？
So what was the topic that was there to discuss?
叫做教会圣工合一发展。
They talked about the unity of the church works.
在这些基督教派他们的观念里面。
So among all the Christian denominations.
他说我们基督教信仰的是同一位天上的真神耶稣基督。
They all believe that we believe in the same God, Lord Jesus Christ.
我们基督教有一个共同的经典，就是只有这一本圣经。
And we all use the same text, this Bible.
那同一个神，同一本圣经。
We have the same God, the same Bible.
我们就不要再分教派。
So we shouldn't have so many denominations.
因为教派是人的产物。
Now denomination is a product of humans.
他们这样讲他说一个手一个健全的手有五根手指头。
So they say a healthy hand should have five digits.
但是你会发现这五根手指头的长短都不一样。
But you'll find that your thumb and your fingers, they all have different lengths.
但他们都是手的一部分。
But they're all part of your hand.
所有的基督教都是耶稣基督的教会。
So that all the denominations of Christian is church belonging to Christ.
每一个基督教会它设立它成立的时间也都不一样。
Every Christian denomination is established at different times.
所以我们呢，不要去用人的观念去分教派。
So we shouldn't differentiate among ourselves as if we are using the thinkings of men.
我们只要欣赏这个教派的特色，这样就好了。
We need to appreciate that every denomination has its own characters.
所以我们摒弃教派的成见，大家合一来传扬耶稣基督。
And so we should cast aside our differences and preach this Christ together.
那么当时我内心里面听到他们这样子的一种讲法。
So when I heard what they said back then,
我就心里想这对我们真耶稣教会来讲是没有办法共同配合的一件事。
I thought to myself, this is something that true Jesus Church here we cannot accept and do and comply.
因为真理没有合一，圣工就没有办法合一。
For if we are not united in truth, then we cannot be united in our works.
我举一个很简单的例子来讲。
I'll give you a simple example.
我们洗礼是进入耶稣基督的宝血里面与主相交。
And so baptism, we are washed by the blood of Jesus and we commune with God.
那现在我们传讲耶稣，如果有人愿意接受耶稣，进入耶稣基督赦罪的这个什么，这个宝血里面。
And so if we preach the Lord today, and then we say if anyone wants to become Christian and they wanted to accept the washing of the blood,
那现在怎么为他施洗？
So how shall we conduct this baptism?
按照小弟所知道的。
So according to what I know,
我们目前基督教派的洗礼有七种方式。
There are totally seven different ways to conduct baptism within Christian denominations.
那么一个就是点水礼。
First is the sprinkling of the water on the head.
那么以长老教会，我认识的以长老教会当中是一个代表性的教会。
And usually, you can see that Presbyterian is it, they do it this way.
那么一个是洒水礼。
And also, they are another way is to spray water.
他们是用一个比较大的器皿哈，然后经过神父这个加持过，他们叫圣水。
And so they have a vessel of water, and then the pastor will bless it, and then it will become a holy water.
然后他们到外面再清脆的树枝放在圣水里面，这样哈。
So they will go out, take a branch, a tree branch, and they'll dip it in the water and sprinkle on you.
那么我们称之为洒水礼，以天主教当中是一个代表性的教会。
And so this kind of sprinkling is usually used by the Catholic churches.
那第三种呢是水池里面的洗礼。
And the third type is when they go into a container or a tub of water.
那第四种呢是建造浸礼室的一种室内的洗礼。
And the fourth type is where they actually build a room, a purpose-built baptism room, and then they conduct baptism there.
那第五种呢是不必用水就可以洗礼。
And the fifth type, you do not even need to use water.
那么他们这个教派代表性的教派哦，我们在台湾叫惊奇，不是 Amazing， 不是 Amazing 哦，那个一个方有没有？耶和华尼西，耶和华是我的惊奇。那个惊奇的那国旗那种，那个代表性的教会叫惊奇教会。
And so in Taiwan, this the church that uses this method is called in Chinese a banners church.
所以他们布置成一个旗海的走廊。
And so they will actually have a corridor of banners.
那他们接受洗礼的从走廊的这一端经过这个旗海走到那一端。他们的牧师就说：“阿门，阿门，你的罪得到赦免了，你可以进天国了。”
And so for them, if you want to be baptized, you simply walk through that corridor under all the banners, and then their pastor will say, "Amen, amen, you are baptized, you are saved."
那这个是第五种的洗礼方式，
so、
不必水。
Type. You don't even need water.
那第六种呢，我们称之为喷水礼。
And the sixth type is also another type of sprinkling of water.
我们基督教常常运用晚间的时间，借一个广大的广场来举行这个联合的布道聚会。
And so Christians like to use evenings, and then they will use a big ground or some sort of platform to hold evangelistic preaching outreach works.
那等到布道会结束以后，他们的名词叫决志。我决定，我立志，我要相信耶稣基督。
And so for them, at the end of their evangelistic services, people will step up and say, "I resolve, I want to be a Christian."
那么这些人都请他们到广场的中央。
And so these people will go into the middle.
那当时一时受到感动，愿意接受耶稣成为救主的，可能有好几百人。
And usually it will be a multitude, maybe hundreds of people who feel moved, and then they wanted to accept Lord Jesus as their savior.
那都晚上九点半了，十点了，怎么洗礼啊？
And so it will usually be in the night time, 9:30 or 10 o'clock.
一个一个来，太慢了，很耗时间的。
And if you do a baptism one by one, it takes too long.
所以他们就打电话去消防队，请消防车来。
So they will call the fire engine to come.
然后他们就把这个消防栓上面的这个消防的水龙头连接之后，一扭，阿门阿门，天降甘霖，大家都接受耶稣基督的洗礼了。
And they will connect their pipe to the water main, and then they will spray water everywhere and say, "Everybody can accept baptism."
第七种。
And then the seventh time.
是我们圣经有记载的，耶稣基督在流动的活水里面做了示范的洗礼。
Is the baptism that is conducted by Lord Jesus as an example, and that is in a flowing living water?
那如果有人愿意接受耶稣，要接受洗礼。那用哪一种方式洗礼呢
？So if someone wants to accept Lord Jesus as their Savior and wants to be baptized, which method should we use？
有些说啊，简单方便，两滴水就好了。
Some people say just keep it simple, just sprinkle a few drops of water on the head。
有些说不要啦，还是用水池的洗礼哈，比较正式啊。
Some people say no, it's better to use a tub. You got more water。
所以我一直认为，真理如果没有办法合一的话，圣公要合一真的很困难。
And that is why I think that if the truth cannot be united, then we cannot be united in our works.
但是去了，我们就听他们到底在说什么吧。
But since I was there, I listened to what they were saying.
那总是会有这个中场休息的茶点时间。
And of course, there is an intermission, a break time.
所以我在外面用茶点的时候，哎呀，碰到我们大陆真耶稣教会我认识的一个年纪比我大的传道人。
And so during break time when I was having refreshment, I met a preacher from our True Jesus Church in China, and he was older than me.
那因为我曾经到中国大陆跟他一起同工，那么我跟他有一点熟。
Now I knew of him because I worked with him before.
他代表中国大陆的真耶稣教会，我代表台湾的真耶稣教会，一起参加了。
So he was there on behalf of the TJCs in China, and I was there on behalf of the TJCs in Taiwan.
哇，碰到他，我们真的很高兴啊，因为我们同出一源呐。
Now when I saw her, I was very happy because we came from the same place.
那我们正在交谈的时候呢？远远的来的一些我们不认识的这个中国大陆基督教派的牧师们。
Now while we were talking, there were some people who approached us. They were the pastors in China, some other church.
那因为我们的这个识别证啊，我们的名牌好大，好像那个通缉犯的名牌啊。
Now we actually wore very big name tags.
那上面就贴了一个照片，然后写。台湾真耶稣教会代表就是我的名字了，某某某。
And on my big tag, it has my photo and also TJC Taiwan representative and then my name.
所以这几位牧师看到他就一直走过来，哎，台湾来的呀。
And then so these pastors saw me and then they come and wave to me and say, hey, you from Taiwan.
我说是是，我是台湾的代表。
And I say, yes, I'm from Taiwan.
真耶稣教会是我们中国大陆三大原生教会。
And then he,
原来的原生命的生。
And then he said that True Jesus Church is one of the biggest, one of the three biggest church in China.
那么就是1949年之前就已经在中国大陆土生土长的教会。
And it was one of the church that established, that was founded there in China before 1949.
一个是真耶稣教会。
So one of them was True Jesus Church.
那么一个叫做召会。
And the other one is an assembly of God.
召会
It is Assembly of God.
那么另外一个叫安息日会。
And another one is the Seventh Day Adventist.
这个是中国三大原生教会。
So these are the three biggest denominations that was founded in China.
哇，真好啊，碰到你们了、啊！介绍一下你们真耶稣教会的特色吧。
And then, so I'm so happy to see you. That the person said, "Can you introduce to us your characteristics?"
那我当时也说穿西装啊，拉一下我刚刚要讲我们中国大陆这个老前辈说跟我拉一下，我来讲，我来讲。
And while I was getting ready to talk, our my senior, the one from China, our representative said, "I will do it."
老前辈要讲话，我就让给他了。
And I said, since he's the senior, I should give him the chance to say.
说我们真耶稣教会的特色只有两个字，用中文来看只有两个字。
And then, so he says, our TJC, our character is quite simple.
我当时内心里面很高兴，我说阿门，跟我的答案一样，我的答案也是两个字。
And then I thought, oh, he says two words, and I was thinking, amen. This is what I'm thinking too, two words.
他说：“真耶稣教会的特色叫做无胆，没有胆量，无胆。”
And then he says, "Our characteristic is that we are not brave."
我一直看他，真耶稣教会无胆。
And then I looked at him thinking, what do you mean we're not brave?
两个字嘛，啊，我的答案是真理。
But my words is also two words, but in Chinese, but it's actually the truth.
那这些牧师他们就搞不清楚了，哈，说什么？你讲清楚一点可以吗？
Now we were all very confused.
那我们这个老传道他说，哦，我们真耶稣教会无胆有三个要点。
And then he explained that there are three points to this, what I said.
第一个，不敢变更这一本圣经的真理，我们没有那个胆量去变更。
So he said, firstly, we're not brave enough to change the truth in the Bible.
我们看加拉太书第一章第八节跟第九节。
Let us turn to Galatians chapter 1, verse 8 and 9.
在这两节的经文里面。
So in these two passages,
保罗他说，无论是谁来传讲天国福音真理的讯息。
And he says, no matter who it is who comes to preach,
那个人就是天上来的使者也没有关系了。
Even if it is an angel from heaven.
那如果他所传的跟我们，保罗说跟我们所给你们的不一样。
So if anyone were to preach any other gospel to you that is not what we have preached to you.
那你看一下十一节，保罗他说他的福音呢，都是我们的神亲自启示他的。
And then you will know that all the gospel that Paul preached is revealed to him by God.
那我们的神启示保罗，保罗把它写下来之后，成为我们这本圣经里面的部分的内容。他说神的话。
So God's word is revealed to Paul, and he has written it down as it is.
那当然，保罗讲这句话的时候，当时没有新约的部分的圣经。
And of course, when he spoke that, there was no other part of the New Testament.
那换句话说。如果有人传福音给你们，跟这一本旧约圣经上面所记载的不一样。
So in other words, if anyone were to preach to you anything that is different to what is written in the scriptures,
那保罗他说，那个人一定要被咒诅。
Then Paul says that person should be cursed.
那这个老前辈讲到那里，他说，我举一个例子来讲。
So this senior of mine, he gave us an example.
请问今天我们的基督教派是要说第七天的安息圣日，还是第一天的主日？
So he asked, in the Christian church, should we observe the seventh day, the Sabbath day, or the first day, which is Sunday, the Lord's day?
旧约圣经耶和华真神他清楚讲到第七天是安息圣日。
In the scriptures, in the Old Testament, we know that the seventh day is the Sabbath day.
那什么时候我们的基督教派不遵守神的命令？
So when is it that the Christian denomination starts to disobey the Bible's teachings?
然后把安息日变更成为主日。
And turn the Sabbath day into the Lord's day.
哇，他这个一讲哦，这个三个跟我们不一样教派的这些牧师哦，愣了一下，哇，场面很尴尬。
And then, so the moment he said this, these three other pastors, they didn't know what to say, and it was quite awkward.
那如果我们去看这个基督教的历史的演变的这些历史资料。
So if you were to search out Christian histories.
把安息日改成礼拜天的是罗马天主教。
It was the Roman Catholic that changed Sabbath into Sunday.
他们的这个教会历史上面很清楚这样写着。
And it's written in Christianity history records.
在主后336年的老底嘉会议。
So it is in one of the meeting in Laodicea in year 336.
当时罗马天主教的教皇他怎么说？
So the Pope in Roman Catholic Church said,
他说我动用神所赋予给我的绝对无比的权柄。
Then he says he is exercising the absolute authority that God has given him.
我现在决定把安息日星期六改成礼拜日，叫主日。
And has changed that Saturday, the Sabbath day, into Sunday, the Lord's day.
那从此之后，奇怪，基督教派全部都守主日，不守安息日了。
And then since then, all Christian denominations observe the Sunday, the Lord's day.
那你看加拉太书一章九节，保罗说，我讲过的，我现在再讲一次，表示说这个也是很重要。
And so in Galatians chapter 1 verse 9, Paul says, I have said before and I'll say again, meaning it's important.
那如果以我们所认识的现在全世界的基督教派大概只有两个教派守安息日。
In the world, there are only two Christian denominations today that observe the Sabbath day.
好，一个就是我们真耶稣教会。
One is us, True Jesus Church.
我们坚守圣经耶和华真神所定的第七天为安息圣日。
We keep observing the seventh day, that is the Sabbath day the Lord has instituted.
那另外一个教派叫基督复临安息日会。
And the other stout denomination is the Seventh Day Adventist.
好，那真理有三大特色啊。
Now, in the truth, there are three main characteristics.
一个就是不可以变更。
One is that it cannot be changed.
啊，讲到这里，外教派的牧师他们就脸色不好看了。
And so the conversation, once we talked about this, they were not looking very good.
第二个特点是什么？
And what's the second characteristic?
是在启示录二十二章的十八节跟十九节。
It is in Revelation chapter 22, verse 18 and 19.
那么在这两节经文里面，我们可以看到，老约翰他说，这一本圣经的预言怎么样？不可以增加。
Now, John, Elder John said that the prophecies in this book cannot be added upon.
哦，我们这个老传道又举例子啦，好像圣诞节。
And then, so this senior member of mine, he says, for example, Christmas.
那这一讲，他们这几个人的脸色更难看。
And so the moment we talked about this, their face looks even worse.
哦，那剩两个守安息日的教派，我还要再删除一个，因为基督复临安息日会。有圣诞节。
So we have mentioned the two generations that observe the Sabbath. Now I have to take away the Seventh Day Adventists now because they keep them. They observe the Christmas celebrations.
那如果你去看历史资料，为什么十月二十五日变成圣诞节
？If you were to look into history, historical record, how has December 25th, sorry, become Christmas?
这个是这个希腊的这个君士坦丁大帝他注定的。
Now it was actually created by a Emperor Constantine.
他为了融合犹太人跟他统治国家，能够变成一个大的一个什么有主权的国家。
And the reason was purely political.
所以他就把当时太阳教太阳神他们的国教的生日十月二十五日，注定为耶稣基督降生的生日。
So he took their main, their state religion, which believes in the sun god, and this god, this deity has a birthday, which is December 25th, and then he put it in Christian church.
这个是圣经我们的神没有告诉我们的真理啊，没有告诉我们的。
And it
这个不是真理。
A piece of teaching that is not in the Bible.
所以就剩下一个教派没有安息日，就是真耶稣教会。
And so we have one denomination remaining, and that is True Jesus Church.
那真理第三个特色是什么？不可以减少。
Now the third characteristic of the truth is that you cannot take away from it.
我们老传道讲，好像洗脚礼。
And then so this preacher said, for example, foot washing sacrament.
全世界没有一个基督教派承认洗脚跟得救相关。
Now, no other Christian denomination except foot washing adds something relevant to salvation.
只有真耶稣教会不敢删减。
Only True Jesus Church is not brave enough to take it away.
因为我们的根据是约翰福音十三章第八节。
And our reference is John chapter 13.
耶稣告诉彼得说，我不洗你的脚，你就与我无份了。
Because Lord Jesus says, if I do not wash your feet, you will have no part with me.
所以如果我们从神的教会必须要具备的真理这个条件，我要去连连看，我要去连哪一个教会他所传讲的是在真理里面。
So if we want to look at what are the main criteria, which is having the truth, then you can look at all the denominations, whichever one actually fits this truth.
那么以小弟个人的选择，我会连接到真耶稣教会。
So if you were to match it up, you'll find that it is only True Jesus Church that matches all the requirement of the truth.
我现在讲神的教会的第二个条件。
Now talk about the second of the criteria.
我们来看以弗所书第一章。
Let us turn to Ephesians chapter 1.
以弗所书第一章的二十三节。
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 23.
上半节我们早上有提过，证明神的教会是唯一的。
So this morning we talked about that the church, there is only one and only.
那下半节就是在讲到这一间唯一神的教会必须要具备什么样的条件。
So this afternoon we'll talk about what kind of criteria this church must fulfill to be the church of God.
那圣经记载说，神的教会是那充满万有者所充满的。
And it says that the church of God has the fullness of him who fills it all in all.
那这句话到底代表什么样的意思呢？
So what does this mean?
我们都知道在约翰福音第四章的二十四节。
In John chapter 4 verse 25,
耶稣基督他说了，他说什么？他说神是灵。
Lord Jesus says that God is spirit.
那神是灵，我们今天要敬拜这一位神，我们是用我们心灵，中文圣经说成熟了，其实那是真理了，用我们的心灵跟用神给我们的真理，我们去崇拜他。
Now because God is spirit, so those who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
好，所以耶稣基督讲说神是灵。
Lord Jesus says God is spirit.
那这个是一个很模糊的概念，什么叫做神是灵？
This seems very vague, and so what does it mean, God is Spirit?
到底这个神是灵，它具备什么样的特色？
So what characteristic does it have?
我们再回到以弗所书第四章第六节。
Let us turn to Ephesians chapter 4 verse 6.
以弗所书第四章第六节。
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 6.
他说只有一位神。
There is only one God.
那这个神就是我们众人灵魂的父亲。
And this God is the Father of all.
因为我们生命的气息是由他所赏赐的。
Because our life, our breath is all from him.
那这一位神他的特色，他的属性是什么呢？
And what is the characteristic of this God?
在我们之上，超乎众人之上。
It says that he is above all.
他在我们生活的周围。
Is also through all.
万乎众人之中。
He is also through all among all.
然后呢，能够进入到我们的心灵、内心世界里面、身体里面。
And he can also enter us all.
那到底有什么东西是有这样子的特色？
So what is something that has these kind of characteristics?
在我们之上。
It is above all.
在我们身体的四周。
Also through all.
又能够进入到我们的身体里面。
But also in us all.
感谢神，在神所创造的这个物质界里面。
So in this material world.
有一样东西就是有这样子的特质。
There is only one thing that has this characteristic.
那么这个东西叫空气。
This is called air.
在我们之上。
It is above us.
空气在身体周围。
It is also around us.
空气能够进入我们的心灵，进入我们的内心，我们的身体里面。
It can also enter into our bodies.
那空气现在在奥克兰，在我们东奥克兰教会，请问在不在台湾？
It is, the air is in...Auckland,
请问在不在非洲？
Is it in Africa?
请问在不在欧洲？在不在美洲？
Is it in Australia?
看不到，摸不到。
It is something you cannot see and cannot touch.
可是透过我们的呼吸，我们不能否认它是存在的。
But through our action of breathing, we cannot deny that it truly exists.
那空气呢？它是地球版的， now, 地球版的。
Now air surrounds this earth.
你只要在这个地球，你走到哪里，空气就在哪里。
So that no matter where you go on this earth, you will know it is there.
那神呢？神他是宇宙版的。
But God fills the universe.
这位神我们看不到，我们摸不到。
This God whom we cannot see or nor can we touch.
但是这位神呢，我们能够感受得到，因为他能够进入我们的心灵世界里面。
But we can feel him because he can enter into our heart.
那么就是圣灵，神的灵，就是神圣的神的灵，能够进入到我们的内心世界里面。
And it is God's Spirit, and that is the Holy Spirit that can enter our heart.
所以以弗所书一章二十三节的下半节。
And so in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 23,
他说教会是耶稣基督是这一位独一真神的身体。
It says that church is Jesus' body.
那属神的教会要有神的圣灵充满在这间教会里面。
And the church of God must have the fullness of the Spirit of God in the church.
所以我说神他是宇宙版的，神现在在地球，神现在也在火星，神现在也在水星上面，到处我们的神都充满在整个宇宙当中。
And God also fills the universe. He is on earth, he's also on Mars, he's also on Venus.
怎么样证明你现在所住的房子是你的房子？
So how can you prove that the house that you live in now is your house?
如果大家有机会来到什么人的家里，然后我们问说，明正，这个房子是你的吗？
So if you have the chance to visit someone else, you can go, hey, is this your house?
他说，是啊，是我的啊。
And you might say, yeah, it's my house.
证明了来。
Where's your proof?
你不能够一只嘴巴两片嘴唇动一动，这是我的，那它就是我的啊，是不是这样？
You can't prove it is your house simply by saying that it is yours.
我们不能够在教会里面听到教会的人说啊，这个是神的教会。对不起，证据拿来。你不能够两片嘴唇动一动，说这是神的教会，那它就是神的教会吗？打问号。
So if we go to a church, we can't simply take the people there's word to say it is God's church. We can't take it for granted that it is God's church.
所以人讲的不算数， 大家都可以讲。
Because anybody can say anything.
那既然是神的教会，神有没有给证据说这一间就是我的教会？
So if a church belongs to God, then God must give the church a proof to say that this is God's church.
好像这个是我的房子，我有政府啊，我有政府合法给我的权状啊。
So for example, if you want to say that this house belongs to me, then there must be some sort of legal documents to prove it.
我拿得出证据啊。
So I can show you the proof to say that this is my house.
所以神的教会，我们的神要承认说这个是我的教会。
So if our God were to acknowledge that this is my church,
那我们的神就从天上赏赐圣灵来印证，告诉大家说这一间就是我的教会，我给他证据。
Then our God will send down the Holy Spirit to this church to say this is my church.
而且圣经告诉我们说哈，真理跟圣灵是要画上等号的。
And the Bible also teaches us that the truth and the Holy Spirit are the same.
在约翰一书第五章第七节。
And that is in 1 John chapter 5 verse 7.
如果你看到这段经文，这段经文讲的最后这句话就是说，真理等于圣灵，真理就是圣灵。
It tells you that the Word and the Holy Spirit are the same; they are one.
所以真理跟圣灵它是连体婴，是一个铜板的两面。
And so, Holy Spirit and the truth, it is like two sides of the same coin.
有真理的教会。
And a church that has the truth,
我们的神就赏赐圣灵来印证这一间是我的教会。
Our God will give this church the Holy Spirit to prove that this is God's church.
我们的神赏赐圣灵在这间教会里面。
Our God gives this church the Holy Spirit.
那就是表示这间教会他们所传讲的福音的讯息都有圣经的根据。
Then it proves that the teachings that this church preaches has the biblical truth as foundation.
所以你要在有真理的教会祷告，我们的神才会赏赐圣灵。
So you need to pray in the church that has the truth, then God will grant you the Holy Spirit.
所以保罗他说哈，这个受圣灵说方言哈，是为不信的人，就是还不认识耶稣的、不认识神教会的这些人提供一个证据。
And so Paul says that when we pray in the spirit and we speak in tongue, it is a proof to the non-believers.
我们请看哥林多前书十四章。
Let us turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 14.
请看二十二节。
Verse 22.
哥林多前书十四章二十二节。
1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 22.
这样看来，说谎言不是为信的人做证据，乃是为不信的人。好，我们再请看二十三节。所以全教会聚在一处的时候，若多说方言，偶然有不通方言的或是不信的人进来，岂不说你们癫狂了吗？好，是全教会所有的每一个人都要能够得到神所赏赐的圣灵。
And so the whole church, everyone in the congregation won't be able to receive this Holy Spirit.
所以这里保罗他说全教会说方言。
It says the whole church comes together and they speak in tongue.
那这个是为不信的人提供一个证据。
This is a sign for the unbelievers.
来证明说我们这间教会就是耶稣基督所建立的神的教会。
To prove that this church is the church established by God.
那如果从这个角度我再去连连看，我要连到哪一间教会全教会祷告都能够说方言。
So if we look at this piece of criteria and it matches up to all the denominations today, what can I find?
我又连到真耶稣教会。
I can only see True Jesus Church as the one that fits this criteria.
只有在真耶稣教会祷告，你可以得到神所赏赐的圣灵。
Only if you pray in True Jesus Church can you receive this Holy Spirit.
我们能够说方言，用舌头发出震动的声音，那么来歌颂天上的神。
We can speak in tongues to sing our praises to the Lord.
好，我来讲第三个条件。
Now the third criterion.
好，我们来看旧约圣经的申命记十二章。
Let us turn to Deuteronomy chapter 12.
好，请看申命记十二章第五节。
Chapter 12, verse 5.
耶和华你们的神从你们各支派中选择何处为地他名的居所，你们就当往那里去求问。再看13节跟14节。
13 and 14.
我们的神说，你要谨慎，不可在你所看中的各处献燔祭，唯独耶和华从你哪一个支派中所选择的地方，你就要到那里献燔祭，行我一切所吩咐你的。我刚开始看到这段经文，我不了解到底它代表什么意思。
So when I first time I read this, I did not understand the significance it had.
旧约时代最重要，在他们整个信仰的内涵当中，就是五大祭、七大节期。
One of the important, most important essence of their belief in Old Testament is these five sacrifices, the offerings.
那旧约时代，这里生命是神透过摩西所写的给以色列百姓的言语。
And so this is the words written for the Israelites.
好，那请问在旧约的十二个支派当中，有不属神的支派吗？
So among the 12 tribes of Israel, is there anyone that does not belong to God?
雅各被神改名叫以色列，生了十二个孩子。
Jacob's name was changed to Israel by God, and then he had
那我们都知道，这个就是以色列的十二个支派。
And then turned into 12 tribes of Israel.
那我们的神怎么会透过摩西告诉这些以色列百姓？
So why would God talk to these Israelites through Moses?
他说在你们这个这十二个支派当中，我会选一个支派哦，不是你看中的支派，你去那里献祭就可以哦，不可以这样。
And then why would God say to them that among you I will choose one of your tribes?
所以第五节就是说选择第五节连接到十四节，我会选择一个支派。
So if we read verse 5 and verse 14, it says that God will choose one tribe.
那这一个支派呢，我会把我的名立在上面。
And then upon this tribe, I will place my name on him.
所以13节我们的神告诉以色列百姓，不要你看上哪一个地方，流便支派哪一个支派的什么地方，我们就去那里献祭，不可以这样。
So that's why verse 13 God says that it is not a place that you choose wherever you want to go to make your burnt offerings.
好，那这个12章里面有很多就是你要到神所选择的地方出现很多次哦。
Now in this chapter 12, many times it says, go to the place that God has chosen.
比如说第五节出现过。
For example, in verse 5.
然后十四节出现过。
And in verse 14.
十八节你再看出现过。
And in verse 18.
二十一节出现过。
Also verse 21.
二十六节也出现过。
And also verse 26.
我们的神都再三强调是我选择立为我名的那个居所，你们才可以去。
So God has said that,God chooses the place for his dwelling place.
好，我们再跳过来申命记十六章。
Let us turn to Deuteronomy chapter 16.
好，这个是他们的献祭，我们的神告诉他们的话。这个是他们守节的时候。
So while they keep their festivals, God said to them,
献祭要到神主定立有神居立有神名字的居所。你要去选择那个地方。
Then when you offer your offerings, you need to go to a place that God has placed His name upon.
那守节也是一样。
Likewise, when you keep your festivals.
我们看十六章的第二节，这个是守逾越节。
So let's read chapter 16, verse 2. It is about the Passover.
说你当在耶和华所选择立为他名的居所，到那里去守逾越节。
Says you need to keep observe your Passover in the place where the Lord chooses to put His name.
再看第六节
，and in verse 6，
也是讲到耶和华所选择立他名的地方去守。
So again, go to the place where the Lord God chooses to make His name.
那么再来是七七节了，就是五旬节了。
Then the Feast of the Weeks.
哦，你看第十一节。
Verse 11.
好，也是要到耶和华你神所选择地为他名的居所。
You also need to go to the place where the Lord your God chooses.
那再来住棚节啦。
And then the Feast of the Tabernacles.
你看第十五节。
Verse 15.
一样到神所选择地为他名的居所，去那边守节。
Again, go to the place which the Lord chooses, where the name abides.
好，所以十六节就是一个结论。
So verse 16 is a conclusion.
你无论向神所哪一种节日，
no matter what festivals or feast that you observe,
你要到神所选择的地方。
You need to go to the place that God chooses.
以色列十二个支派，每一个支派都是神的选民，怎么神讲这种话呢？
So all 12 tribes of Israel are God's people. Why does God say this then?
那后来啊，去查考啊，这个选择它的这个原文的这个文化。
And then, so if you look at the look into the word in the original text for the word chooses, now this word is actually future but incomplete.
啊，什么叫做未完成事呢？
So what does that mean?
就是说，当时我们的神讲这个话的时候，他没有完成选择。
It means that when he says the Lord chooses, he actually hasn't made the choice yet.
那么在神所命定的那个时候到的时候，这一件事情就会兑现。
In the future, at the appointed time, this thing will come to completion.
好，那么就好像加拉太书第四章第四节所记载的。
Just like in Galatians chapter 4, verse 4.
哦，说等到时候满足啊，哦，神的救赎经纶是有时间的，哦，是有时间的这个计划期的。
So it says, but when the fullness of time had come, so.There is a time element to God's plan.
所以要等到神他所命定的那个时候已经满足了，那么这个事情他才会兑现，才会成立。
So this will only be come to completion at the appointed time.
而且你回到旧约看，耶和华神所选择立他名的居所，这个居所原文是单数讲一个地方，不是讲十二个地方、八个地方。单数一个地方。
And when you read back to Deuteronomy, you'll find that this place that God chooses to put His name on or to be His dwelling place, this is singular, one place.
我们天上这位神叫什么名字？
So what is the name of our Heavenly Father, this God?
在旧约的时代，有很多属神的选民一直要了解神啊，你到底叫什么名字？
In the Old Testament time, there were many of God's people who want to know the name of God.
比如说啊，电脑做一下哈，创世纪三十二章二十九节。
For example, let us turn to Genesis.
三十二章二十九节。
Chapter 32, verse 29.
这个是雅各跟神在亚伯河摔跤。
So this is when Jacob wrestled with God.
那当时雅各就问啊，请问你叫什么名字啊？
And Jacob asked, "What is your name?"
你看当时我们天上的神啊，所化身的使者跟他怎么讲？问我名字干嘛？你不必知道我名字了，因为时候还没有到。
And that man said to him, "Why is it you ask about my name?" And he wouldn't tell him because it was not the right time.、
那到了摩西的时代。
Then in Moses' time,
在出埃及记第三章的十三节到十四节。
In Exodus chapter 3, verse 13 and 14,
神叫摩西说，去带领以色列百姓离开埃及。
God told Moses to lead the Israelites out of Egypt.
那摩西就问神啊。
So Moses asked God,
我去带领以色列百姓，如果这个百姓问我说，哪个神叫你来的啊？
If I were to lead these people, what if they say to me that what is the God that has sent you?
那我怎么告诉他们呢？到底是哪一个神啊？
What should I say to them? What is your name?
所以你要把你的名字跟我讲啊，让我能够去告诉他们是哪一个神叫我来的啊。
So you need to tell me who you are, so I can tell them which God has sent for me.
可是因为时候还没有到，所以神只有跟摩西说，你去告诉他们那个自由拥有的神叫我来的。
But because the time has not yet come, so God only said to Moses, I am who I am.
好，那么到了到了这个以赛亚先知的时代。
Now in the time of Isaiah.
以赛亚先知在神的灵感动之下。
So prophet Isaiah was moved by the Spirit of God.
那么在以赛亚书第九章的第六节。
In Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6.
好像神感动他要把神的名字告诉他。
It is like that God has moved him to tell him this name.
那可是以赛亚先知在神的灵感动之下，他说讲出来的神的名字 没有一个是神的名字。
But under the movement of the Spirit of God, this name that came to Isaiah was actually not a real name.
那么都是神属性的一个代名词形容。
There were only words that describes the characteristics of God.
哦，所以他说他的名字哦叫奇妙，叫测试，叫全能的神，永在的父，和平的君，没有一个是神的专有名词的名字的，没有。
So he said that his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, but none of them are real names.
因为神的时候都还没有到。
Because God's time was not yet come.
那这个神叫什么名字呢？
So what is this name of God?
到的马太福音第一章的二十一节。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 1 verse 21.
当玛利亚身孕已经重了，要生出这个婴孩的时候，我们的神就差派天使来告诉约瑟说，这个孩子出生，你就把他取名叫耶稣。
And so when Mary has conceived and she was about to give birth, and then so messenger of God went to her and said that you will call him Jesus.
因为我们的神已经正式在这个世界启动他拯救世上万人的救赎计划。
And that is when God has executed his salvation plan in this world.
所以神的时候到了，他就把他的名字启示给世人。
And so when the time has come, God revealed to mankind his name.
哦，那么在《使徒行传》第十章的十二节。
And in Acts,
使徒们做见证。
In Acts, chapter 4, verse 12, they testified.
天下人间啊，我们的神没有赐下别的名，我们可以靠着得救啊，只有一个名啊，这个名是什么？是圣的名字，就叫耶稣。
That in this world there is no other name by which we can be saved, and this name is Jesus.
在旧约时代，我们的真神讲，我会选择一个地方，一个居所，我会把我的名放在上面。
So in the Old Testament, we see that God would choose a place as his dwelling place where he will put his name on.
那你们就到那个地方来敬拜我。
And that is the place you will go and worship me.
那请问现在这么多的基督教派，有哪一个教派把神的名立在他们的居所上面？
Now today, among all the Christian denominations, which one of them actually uses the name of God upon them?
我觉得很奇妙的哦，到目前为止我知道的只有真耶稣教会。
And as far as I know,there's only one that is true Jesus Church.
可能还没有看到有任何的教派，都知道是基督教，可是都没有耶稣的名在他们的居所上面。
So there is
立在居所上。
No other denominations yet, to my knowledge, that actually has the name of God, uses the name as their dwelling place.
所以如果我们去看真耶稣教会，这个会名到底是怎么来的？
So if we look at the origin of this name, True Jesus Church,
那在1917年，我们的神用圣灵兴起他第二次的教会，就是末世拯救人灵魂的教会。
So in 1917, God establishes true church again.
我们的第一个被神所选的工人叫卫保罗。
And the first worker that God had chosen was Paul Way.
我们的神就启示卫保罗说，我的教会叫真耶稣教会，这个名字是神给我们的。
God revealed to Paul that Paul Way that my church's name is True Jesus Church.
我的资料来演示我们这个中国大陆我们的这个真耶稣教会总部他们的这个文宣处的处负责叫郑家正传道，他写的真耶稣教会的起源查考里面所提供的资料。
Now this piece of information is referenced from our historical record from China.
所以我们如果再从这个角度去连接神的教会，一个预言的兑现在末世，那只有真耶稣教会把神的名标示在上面。
So today we can see that only True Jesus Church used the name of God Jesus and raised his name as the name of the church.
那这些
messages of from God is in the Bible.
而且三者齐备，不是具备一个条件，是三个条件齐备，全部都要。
And then this church must fulfill all three criteria, not just one.
神的教会要有真理。
So the church of God must have the truth.
神的教会要有神圣灵的印证。
And must have the proof of the Holy Spirit.
神的教会要有神的名在上面。
And the church must also raise the name of God.
到目前为止，我就找到一间教会符合圣经这些条件。
And so far, only one church I know that fulfills all these criteria.
那么这一间神的教会叫真耶稣教会。
And this church of God is called True Jesus Church.
期待大家都能够来了解圣经我们的神所告诉我们的这一些真理。
I hope that we can all come to understand the truth that God reveals to us.
我们最后来看马太福音七章二十一节。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 7, verse 21.
这一马太福音七章二十一节，耶稣说：“凡称我主啊、主啊的人，不会都进天国。”
So in Matthew chapter 7, verse 21 says, "Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven."
只有一种人才可以进去。
Only one kind of people can enter.
所以圣经说唯独就说只有这一种人，唯独遵行我天父旨意的人才可以进去。
It says, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven.
所以我们要了解这么多基督教派大家都称呼耶稣是主啊主啊，对不起，照圣经真理来行的这一间唯一的神的教会的选民才能够进入神永生的国度。
So even though so many Christian denominations call the Lord Lord, but not all of them will enter the heavenly kingdom. Only the one that follows the truth.
那求神的灵来感动带领我们。
May the Spirit of God move us.
让我们都能够在宗教信仰的选择当中选择进入的这一间唯一的一间让灵魂可以得救的真耶稣教会。
So that in our choice of religion, we choose the one that leads to salvation.
愿一切的荣耀归给天上的神。
May all the glory be given to our God in Christ.